Today, we're going to look into how to automatically pick an item off a list with make.com no code. So, like you might have a Google Sheet with multiple rows, you might have an A-table database with multiple records, or you have any other module that outputs multiple bundles on Make, and you want to pick one of these bundles randomly. That's what we're going to look into, so stay tuned. Hey, my name is Manuel and I'm the founder of techflow.ai and we love automation. If you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, do so below please and stay tuned for more videos. If you have any questions or ideas for upcoming videos, just put them in the comments below and we will create videos exactly for you and for your use cases and questions. So let's jump into our scenario and I will walk you through a simple sample. We have like a Google Sheet database or a Google Sheet list of, let's say it's a lottery and we have a lot of applicants here, and then we want to pick one of these applicants randomly, and that's what we're going to look into. So first we're going to need a Google Sheet to search the rows of this First, we're going to need the Google Sheets module, search rows, and search from this Google Sheet. So I will pick the sheet ID and paste it in here because that's usually the easiest and fastest way to find the Google Sheet. And the sheet name is the names. And then we want to return all of them. So we don't want to have a limit here, but we want to make sure that those who have won before are not being included. So we have the one column here. That's like a status column. I've mentioned that a couple of times before. We really like to add these status columns into a Google Sheet because we're into kind of anything that you want to update or any database, because that really helps to filter at the beginning and not rerun the same records again and again. So only if one does not exist, so there's no entry yet in one, that means they have not won before, and then press OK and let's run once to see what the output looks like. We are getting all these different bundles, so five different bundles because we have five names, and now we want to pick one of these randomly. How can we do this? There are of course like always multiple ways of doing that, but I will show you a simple way that will always work no matter how many results you will be returning here, and that is using very limited functions. So we are using the array aggregator because we want to get it into one bundle first, and we are using the search rows as the input, then the row number as output, and the name and the email address, and if you want to you can also include the one, it's not necessary. And then pressing OK, and this will allow us to get all into one array, and with that one array we can work. So we now have one array with all rows combined, and the simple hack here, or the trick, is that we are using a set variable module to shuffle our array items. So winner, and now we are using this array and we're using the array functions over here. If you are not familiar with the functions, don't worry, we have the make functions cheat sheet, it's below this video, you can find it in the description. Just download it and it will explain all of these functions very detailed with examples and how you can apply them, and they're super powerful, so it's definitely worth looking into how to work with these functions and really mastering them. Let's jump back. We have the shuffle function over here, and that randomly reorders elements of an array. That's exactly what we want to do here. So let's use the shuffle function, and what it does now is, if we run this again, we have like it reordered. So now Max is the first one, then Tony, then John Doe, and then Manuel, and then Matt. So you can see the row number, it's completely mixed up now, 4, 5, 6, 2, 3. And if we try it again, it should have different row numbers. So let's see, yeah, we have 6, 3, 5, 2, and 4 now. So that really randomizes everything. And now we wanna pick one of them. And we can simply say, okay, we always pick the first one because it's randomized anyways. So the first one should be good. And then it works no matter how many items we have in our array. We could also say last, doesn't matter actually. So there's the first and the last function. it's this one over here, which returns the first element of an array, and the last one returns the last element of an array. So you can pick one of those. It doesn't matter really, because it's randomized anyways. And now we are just getting one winner back. So that's one item in the very end. And now we have Matt and row number 3. And the last thing we want to do is we want to make sure that this person is not getting a prize twice. So let's use an update a row module where we use the output of this set regular module. And again, we are selecting from all, entering the spreadsheet ID that we have here. And then we'll pull all the information. We are selecting the sheet name. Oops. And then the row number, we can map it from here. So it's this one over here. And then the table contains name, email address. We don't want to change it, but for one, we want to say yes. So that means, okay, that person has already won before. You can also put a date in here, like a timestamp if you wanted to, or whatever you like to add here, or also the price. If you're randomizing the price give out, then you can use that over here. So, all right. And now let's run this one more time and see who won. It was Matt, and the one column is set. So now the next time it should only output 4 values, and this person should not win anymore. So yeah, we have 4, and the winner this time was me.
Nice.
All right, and if you do it again, just for the sake of completeness, we have 3 now. And it picked a new winner, who is John Doe. All right, the last step, always rename your module so you actually know what it does. Search all participants, array aggregator. We don't need to rename that. Then shuffle and pick first. Update one status column. Like, I highly recommend renaming your modules every single time, like once you're done or while you're developing something, because it's so much easier when you get back into this and want to know, okay, what was it actually that I did there? And it will be easy to see right away, and you don't have to worry about it. Then also rename your scenario. Pick a random item from a list with make.com. So I will also share the blueprint of this scenario, so just check out the description below this video and you can download the blueprint if you want to apply to your own scenario. Just go to 3 dots and then import blueprint and choose the file here that you've just downloaded. It's a .json file, and then you will have the exact same scenario here, and you can apply it to whatever you want to do or use for it. And then, of course, like as I mentioned before, you can replace this one here with any module that outputs multiple bundles and then pick one of this randomly so you can use it. I hope it helped. And if you have any ideas for future videos, any questions about make.com, just put them in the comments below this video and we will create the content for you and help you out, because we really want to help you grow with Make, grow with automation, and leverage the true power of it. Thank you for watching.